All right, let's get serious now. We need to move to using a real task to fetch the weather. After all, weather is serious business. Let's create a separate fetch weather task to populate our content provider database. And we'll start by moving our existing task over to this new one. Wow, it's good to get that big task out of forecast fragment. And we're going to change the parameters to string void void. Oh, we've got a lot of compile errors to fix. That's okay. For now, we're going to delete everything except for the do in background part of the async task. Let's give it a constructor and pass in a context. In do in background, let's save off the location query as a string to make the code easier to understand. And for fun, let's fetch the maximum 14 days of forecast data. Since we've temporarily deleted getWeather data from JSON, we can remove it from the try-catch at the bottom. We're going to look for lots of additional data from the OpenWeather API. To make this easy, here are the strings we'll use. We'll also get the city name, the latitude, and longitude returned by OpenWeather. Now, we do have to wrap this in a try in order to make sure that we handle the exception. All right, now we've handled the exception so everything compiles. And hey, look, we've got the city name and coordinates. We've now gotten the location that we can use to insert things into the database. And we haven't done this in a while, so it's time for a programming exercise. But before we can do that, let's actually make sure that your app can really compile. Let's go back to forecast fragment and take a look at how fetch weather task is working. One is that fetch weather task is going to require that we get an activity or some other context and pass that in there. Another thing we can do is remove these pesky shared preferences. And there we have it, a utility function that gets us our preferred location. All right, so now we're ready to run the application so we can actually do the next exercise. Once again, we're going to be calling into our very new fetch weather task, but it's not going to do anything other than trying to read some JSON. So we've got to make it do something beyond that.